the last class, we have seen graphical representation of motion. In graphical representation of motion, first kind of graph is distance versus time graph, and second kind of graph we have velocity time graph. Velocity time graph is representation of velocity, means change in velocity, with time. The variation in the velocity of object moving on the straight line with time can be represented by velocity time graph. In the velocity time graph, we have to write velocity on y-axis and time on x-axis in our required unit. Here we take hour for time and kilometer per hour for velocity. If an object moves with uniform velocity, then graph of velocity versus time will be a straight line which is parallel to x-axis. In this example, we have a car moving with velocity 40 km per hour. In velocity versus time graph, product of velocity and time gives us magnitude of displacement. How? We know that formula for the velocity is displacement divide time. If we multiply this formula of velocity with time, this time will be cut and we get displacement. And this magnitude of displacement will be equal to area enclosed by velocity time graph and time axis. Let us take one example. Let us take two points C and D. I give name C to this point and point D to this point. Let us say here time is t1 and here time is t2, which means car takes t2 minus t1 time to reach D from C. Got it? Which means car takes t2 minus t1 time. Here time to reach at D from C equal to t2 minus t1, and obviously here the unit is R. Now at the time t1, velocity of the car is 40 km per hour, and at time t2 also velocity of the car is 40 km per hour. So to get displacement, to get displacement of car, we need to multiply velocity with time. Here velocity is 40 km per hour multiply. Time is t2 minus t1. That is 3 minus 1, which is 2r. So let us multiply with 2r and we will get the answer. Displacement, let's represent displacement as S, is 40 multiplied 2, that is 80. Here HHR is cut and our answer will be in 80 km. So in this way, we can find distance traveled by object from the velocity time graph. Now let us take graph for velocity time for uniformly accelerated motion. Now we know that what is uniformly accelerated motion. Change in the velocity of object will be similar in every time interval. Let us take one example. In this example, every 5 second of time intervals, change in the velocity will be 2 meter per second. Let us say at first 5 seconds, velocity increases to 2 meter per second. At second 5 seconds, that is 5 to 10 second of interval, velocity increases further 2 meter per second. And next 5 second of time interval, velocity increases another 2 meter per second, which means for every 5 seconds of time intervals, velocity increases to 2 meter per second each time. For uniformly accelerated motion, graph of velocity time will be always straight line. We can also find distance traveled by object from velocity time graph. How can we find distance covered by object from this graph? It is as similar as we seen in the previous graph of velocity time graph. That is area enclosed by velocity time graph and time axis. Area enclosed by velocity time graph and time axis. Let us take two points B and C. We want to calculate distance covered by the object in this 20 minus 10 means 10 seconds of time. We want to see how much distance will be covered by this 10 second by object. So let us find area under this graph, means this A and E, area under AE. So area under AE is this much, A, B, C, D, E. Now we can divide this area in two part. Let us say A, B, C, D and A, D, E, which is our known part, that is A, B, C, D rectangle and A, D, E right angle triangle. So here I write distance covered as is equal to area under graph. Area under graph is A, B, C, D, E. Area under graph is area of A, B, C, D, E. We divide this area in two known part, that is area of rectangle A, B, C, D and area of right angle triangle A, D, E. Area of right angle triangle and area of rectangle are known to us. That is length into breadth. So in case of ABCD, area will be BC length into AB breadth. So I write here AB into BC. Plus area of right angle triangle is half into base, that is AD. So I write AD into altitude ED. So I write AD. Let us put values. AB, here AB is 4 meter per second, so 4 into BC is 20 minus 10, that is 10, plus AD is also 10, so 10. ED is 8 minus 4, that is 4. And by simple calculation, we get the answer 60 meters, which means in the time interval of 10 to 20 seconds, the distance covered by this object will be 60 meters.